In this example, figure shows a potentiometer with length of wire 1 meter. Here the potentiometer wire is the wire PQ and it is of resistance 10 ohm. And in this situation, we are required to find the length PC when the galvanometer shows null deflection. Now in this situation, if we solve the problem, first let us calculate the current in primary circuit. Here all parameters in primary circuit are known. So current in primary circuit can be directly given as I is equals to here the primary EMF is 2 volt and the total resistance here is 15 ohm and 10 ohm. So it will be 2 by 10 plus 15. So it will be 2 by 25 ampere, that is the current in circuit. If we calculate the potential gradient in wire, then the value of lambda can be directly written as potential difference across terminals PQ of wire divided by 100, because we are given that it is of length 1 meter. So here VPQ can be written as IR, the current here is 2 by 25 ampere. So it will be 2 by 25 multiplied by resistance is 10 divided by 100. On solving, we are getting it. This 10 gets cancelled out. It is 2 by 250. So it is 1 by 125 volt per centimeter is the potential gradient we are getting on the wire. Now, in this situation, if we calculate the potential difference across points P and C in the circuit, here you can see at null deflection, no current is flowing through galvanometer. So here only current which is flowing will be in this part of the circuit. So here the value of this current in secondary circuit I can be written as 1.5 divided by the total resistance is also 1.5. So your current is 1 ampere and the potential difference across these terminals can be written as 1 multiplied by 0.3. So we can write in secondary circuit potential difference across points P and C is this VPC we can write as 0.3 multiplied by 1, this will be 0.3 volt. Now if this is the potential difference across point P and C, and we can say if a balancing length for this potential difference is L, so we can write if balancing length for VPC on wire is L, this implies we can write VPC is equals to lambda L. This implies the value of L we are getting VPC by lambda. VPC here we are having is 0.3 divided by lambda. We can directly write it as 1 by 125. So it will be 125 multiplied by 0.3, which is equals to 37.5 centimeter. That will be the answer to this problem.